Hello friends, welcome to this video. This is Rohit. Friends, in today's video we are going to talk about the topic called PHP serialization. Now first of all we will try to understand what is serialization, and then I will try to demonstrate you serialization regarding arrays and objects. So first of all, what is serialization? So serialization allow us to convert the state of object to byte stream. This is nothing but serialization. Once you obtain your data in form of byte stream, then you can save it to any file or you can transmit it across your network as well. So serialization allow you to convert your object to string representation. That is nothing but byte stream. So this byte stream can be transferred to file as well. Friends, we know the concept that whenever we create object of any class, so until that object is available within memory, only up to that time you will be able to access the data which is stored within object. Once object is removed from memory, once object is destroyed from memory, you will be not able to access the data that is stored within the object. So what solution you will have? You can convert your object data to byte stream, and this byte stream can be saved to different files. So later on, by reading that file, you will get your original object data again. So for storing your object data to files, we use the concept called serialization. So serialization is a process of converting object data to byte stream. And exactly opposite to that, we have another concept called deserialization. Now in deserialization, we convert byte stream to object again. This is called deserialization. Now why you need deserialization? So whatever data you have stored in form of byte stream of your object, that you can get back in form of object again using the concept of deserialization. So serialization and deserialization, these two concepts are used parallelly for converting our object to byte stream and byte stream to object. Now friends, we can perform this serialization and deserialization regarding arrays, and second thing, we can perform them regarding objects. First of all, I will demonstrate you how you will perform serialization and deserialization regarding arrays, and then we will try to understand how to perform serialization and deserialization regarding object. Now when you need serialization in case of array, so whenever you have certain complex array, multidimensional array within array within array, okay, so whenever you have such a complex array that you need to store within files or that you need to store as a byte stream, then you can go for serialization option. So your array will be converted into byte stream, and then again you can convert that byte stream to array whenever you want. So in PHP, for serialization and deserialization, we have two important functions. So first function is called serialize, and second function is called unserialize. So this serialize function converts object or array to byte stream, and this second function converts byte stream to object or array. So we need to use these two functions for performing serialization and unserialization. So first of all, we will try to create one array and we try to see how we can serialize the array. Okay, so I will create one new file and save this file with name, let's say demo7.php. Now here I will create one array, let's say student is equal to array, and I will store certain names within this array. Okay, this array we have created. Now in order to convert this array to string, in order to serialize this array, we will try to use serialize function here. Okay, and I will take one string here, let's say serialize data is equal to serialize and pass your array name here. So student will be our array name. Now friends, if I print this echo serialize data, I will use h1 here to get output within certain larger font. Okay, now we will go to browser and I will run my file localhost/demo7.php. You can see the output. This is the serialized data. So after serializing your array, you will get this kind of output. This is called byte stream. So your array is converted into byte stream like this. So this byte stream you can store within certain file, you can pass it across your network, okay, wherever you want. This can be done with serialize function. Now next thing, we have unserialize. Now how to get your array back? So how you will convert this byte stream to array again? So we will use a function called unserialize. So here I will write, array name, let's say student data, and I will use unserialize function. Pass your string here which we got from serialize function. So I will write here serialize data. So this serialize data string consists of our byte stream. Okay, now this byte stream will be converted to array again, and elements will be available within student data array. Now friends, if I use printr function for printing the array, we will get our array back. So I will pass here student data. Okay, now see here, you can see we got our array back here like this. Okay, I will use here br tag, so we will be able to clearly see the output. Now see here, this was the serialized data and this is our original array we got back from this serialized data. So to get our array back, we use this unserialized function. So this unserialized function has converted our byte stream to array again. This is how we can serialize array and unserialize array. So here serialize will convert our array to byte stream and unserialize will convert our byte stream to array like this. Now friends, nowadays JSON format is becoming more popular for transmitting data across network, for transmitting data over web. So JSON is nothing but JavaScript object notation, and PHP has support for JSON as well. So you can use two functions for encoding your data to the JSON and getting your data back again. Now friends, in PHP you can use JSON encode and JSON decode functions for converting your data to JSON and vice versa. So I will try to demonstrate that as well here. So you can also convert your data in JSON format. That is also one kind of serialization, you can say. Okay, so here for converting your data into JSON, we have a function called JSON encode. And for decoding our data from JSON, we have function called JSON decode. Okay, so this first function will convert array to JSON format, and this second function will convert JSON format to our original array. Okay, now I will try to remove all these things and we will try to see how to use JSON function. Okay, so here I will use output is equal to JSON encode and pass your array here like this. Okay, now if I print this output string, let's see what we will get. So I will use h1 here again like this. You can see like this we will get the JSON string. Okay, so JSON encode will convert your array to JSON format. So friends, this JSON use only text in order to represent your data, so it can be easily sent to and from server and can be used as data format by different programming languages. Okay, so nowadays JSON is most popular for sending data across network. So for serializing your data, you can use this JSON encode function as well. Now friends, to get your array back, so we will use JSON decode function. So I will write here, let's say yes data, and here I will use JSON decode and pass our JSON string here. So our JSON string was output, and now if I use printr function and if I pass this yes data, so we will get our array back. Okay, okay, there should be output like this. You can see here we got our array back. Like this you can convert your array to JSON format, and again you can get your array back, okay, using this JSON decode function. So JSON encode and JSON decode, these functions are also used for serializing data. So you can use serialize, unserialize, or you can use JSON encode, JSON decode, these functions. Now we will try to see how to serialize objects. Okay, so for serializing objects, we will try to use this serialize and unserialize function. Okay, now I will remove this. Now here I will create one class student, let's say, and I will have one property fname. Okay, and I will initialize it with some value like this, and I will use one function here to display this property value like this, and within this I will just print the property value. So for printing property value, I will use this keyword, object operator, and my property name like this. And now I will create one object here, obj is equal to new student. Now friends, I want to serialize the data of this object. Now what I will do here, I will use serialize function. So see here, I will write output str. So this output str will consist your byte stream, okay, byte stream of our object. Now simply write here serialize and pass your object name. And now if I write echo output str, I will use br here. Okay, now see here, we will get the output which consists our object in form of byte stream. So after converting your object in form of byte stream, you will get this kind of string. Now this string you can store within certain files, and then you can read that file again to get your object back. This is how you can serialize your object. Now how to unserialize, means how to convert this string to object again. So what I will do here, I will create one object name here. Let's say object 1 is equal to, now I will use unserialize function here and pass your string here. So I will write output yest here. And friends, if I try to call now the function using this obj1, so if I call display function here, we will get output. You can see we got the output. Okay, so like this we will serialize and we will unserialize the object using serialize and unserialize function. Now friends, I will try to show you how you can write this serialized data to the file, and again how you can read that file to get your object back. I will change this code like this. I will add one file descriptor here. Let's say file is equal to fopen. Now this fopen function is used for opening a file. Suppose I want to write my data to file called demo.txt. Okay, and I will specify mode here, write mode, like this. Now my file will get open here. Now if my file will get open, I will write it using fwrite function. Okay, so it needs the file descriptor and the string which we need to write. So here I will pass the string called output yest here, and I will simply use fclose function to close our file. So again I will pass file descriptor here like this. Now if I go and run this code, now here the data will be written to file directly. Okay, so if I go to XAMPP directory, htdocs, so here you can see the demo file, and within demo, if I make it somewhat larger font size, you will be able to see this byte stream we have written to our file now, like this. Okay, so friends, we can read this file again and we will get our data back. Now friends, I will try to demonstrate you how we can read our data back. Okay, now again we will open file in read mode. Okay, and now instead of fwrite we will use fread function now to store the output which is written from fread. I will use output data as a variable. Okay, and this function requires first of all the file descriptor, so I will write here dollar file. And now to determine the length of file, I will use built-in function called file size, and just pass your file name here, demo.txt, like this. Now whatever data it will read, it will be available within this output data variable. And now I will use unserialize function. So let's say I will write obj1 is equal to unserialize and pass our string. So what was our string? Output data. So this output data we have got by using this fread function. So this fread function will read the serialized string which is available within this demo.txt file. Okay, and after reading that, it will store output within this output data. So we will pass this output data to unserialize. Now this unserialize function will convert our byte stream to object again. Okay, and now I can display the data of object. So simply I will call, suppose, display method here, obj1 display, and we will get the output. You can see we got output again. Okay, like this we can serialize data and we will store that data to file, and again from file we will read our data and we will get our object back using unserialize. This is how we can perform serialization and unserialization on arrays as well as on object in PHP. Friends, if you find this video useful, please like and share this video. I will see you in next video. Thank you for watching.